treating Zeus, who lost his paw when he was a very young puppy. He has a leg that he could use if he had a proper paw connected to it. And we have made an implant that exactly fits on that arm that will allow us to connect a piece of titanium alloy to the bone, but also to reconstruct his soft tissue to it and to kind of permanently be able to walk on it.
Dr. Marcellin and myself, we've been collaborating for over almost 9 years now, and we've been working on similar projects, but this is probably the most sophisticated to date.
It's particularly exciting surgery because it's a novel concept to be able to connect an implant permanently to a limb and then make a limb useful again.
The collaboration is extremely important for these kind of projects.
We do everything in-house. We evaluated him initially at the vet school.
And then the imaging from that CT scan is transferred over to us in engineering,
where we design his implant and we made it. And then we'll be doing surgery and we'll be managing his limb and his recovery here at the vet school. We draw from the experience and expertise of multiple colleges and a large group of people.
And just like Dr. Marcellin and myself have been collaborating for many years, our students are collaborating.
And graduate students in engineering, we have several veterinarians that participate in different aspects of the surgery and the recovery.
And they're usually the ones that are doing a lot of the work and also a lot of the follow-up. The process basically starts with the patients come to the vet school and they will do a CT scan of the patient, and then the imaging from that CT scan is transferred over to us in engineering. We usually have a meeting with the surgeons. Once we get to something starting to look like something that will work, we're starting using our what is called the additive manufacturing processes, which are machines that are basically 3D printers. So they take the 3D models from the computer and create 3D objects out of polymers. And then through testing, we'll try that. Then we move on to our metal-based systems. And these are also metal printing machines. So they will print out the same implant that we did before in polymers now in titanium, which is a medical-graded metal. Once the implant comes out of there, we do some finishing. And then we'll do new trial surgeries again using the plastic bones. But the most important thing is that all the parties are happy with the final result. The implant that's been completed, it comes back to the vet school for preparation for surgeries where they will do the sterilization. And then the engineering team is usually present during the surgery to see the final result, but also to learn.
We like the idea that our patients, our dogs, benefit from what we do, and humans also might benefit from what we do.